Here are 5 things I hate about Yamaha MT-10, Yamaha FZ-10, Master of Torque, Monster Torque. First up, we need to have a talk with Yamaha because it seems they hired some engineers from their piano department in order to design the seat latching mechanism. Now, considering the fact that this bike costs $16,300 Canadian before taxes and other fees, I think we all have to ask Yamaha in regards to what they were thinking when they were designing this two-wheeled motorized vehicle.
Just look at it. What is this?
Now frankly, when I'm riding the bike, I can't really feel the seat moving underneath me because there's quite a bit of weight on the seat. And if you're concerned about this problem, don't be, because this bike has been out on the market for quite some time now and Yamaha has recognized this problem and did nothing to correct it. Now another issue I have with the seat is the fact that there is a hole between the bike and the seat. Now I'm not a complete expert when it comes to naked bikes, but I know a big point is to expose the frame and the engine for the raw look. Now, don't quote me on this, but I'm pretty sure the ABS pump is not part of the raw look people have been thinking of. I'm sure all the internals will collect dust much quicker than other bikes, example an MT-07, and for all of you that like to pressure wash your bike, I suggest you be really careful, otherwise your bike will drown.
Now, another issue I have with this bike are the rear pegs. Now, I know I could technically remove them, but I kinda like the looks of the rear pegs. And if I was actually to remove them, I need to buy the block off plates, and those things cost quite a bit of money, and I'm not the person that likes spending money.
The problem occurs when I start cornering. I usually get on the edge of my toes on the rear sets. This results in my heels touching the rear pegs, which get pretty annoying. But this problem is solvable with minimal efforts, so it's not a big deal. Also, if you guys are wondering how I'm able to mount my GoPro on the center of my Shobi X14, check out Ritech Moto. We sell custom GoPro mounts for a variety of popular helmets, which contour the curves perfectly.
And if you guys are looking to buy an LCD flip kit, just like this one right over here, we do ship worldwide with low shipping costs. So get yours today. A bigger deal is this gap between the actual gas tank and the plastic cowling.
Now, I understand Yamaha maybe for some reason couldn't install a fully metal gas tank, and that's completely okay with me. That doesn't bother me one bit. What does bother me is the fact that there's 6mm gap between the cowling and the gas tank. Now, the MT-10 being the flagship naked bike coming from Yamaha, I have to ask them, why couldn't they make the plastic flush with the gas tank? In my experience, the dust accumulates really quickly in those crevices, and it just makes the bike look like it's not finished. I knew what I was getting into as I decided to pull the trigger on this beastly machine. And what I'm talking about is the fuel economy and the gas gauge. It seems I have to fill up every single time I ride, and if I don't halfway through, I'll run out. Now, Yamaha did state that this is not their most efficient bike you can purchase from their lineup, so it's not their fault. After all, it's a pretty powerful motor.
And the gas gauge. As you guys can see, the first bar takes up one half of the gas tank, or one half of the gas gauge. So I don't know whether my tank is full right now or it's about to be at half.
First ride reviews and videos are great for finding out how the bike behaves in the first time you get on it. Unfortunately, it takes time to fully get comfortable with any bike, and after a couple of rides, I started feeling quite a bit of delay in the throttle, even in mode 1, which is the most responsive mode.
And it doesn't seem like it's the RPM problem, because the bike reacts at exactly the same at any RPM. So let's say if I'm going in third gear, and I'm applying a little bit of throttle, it doesn't go anywhere. It just, like, I expect the bike to start going when I apply a throttle, but I'm applying it and nothing. And only after about half a second of me applying the throttle, only then the bike starts going and giving me the throttle that I expect from this type of a powerful bike. Take a look. I'm in first gear, I'm applying throttle, there's nothing, and there it goes. I really hope I can fix this with a flash tune or something like that. Take a look again. I'm applying throttle, and there it goes.
Honestly, it was very difficult to find 5 things I disliked about this motorcycle, and in the end, still, this is the funnest and most stable naked bike I have ever ridden. If I was to go back in time, I would buy it again. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Check out Ritech Moto if you're looking to buy custom action camera mounts or LCD flip kits. Many other videos are coming out soon, and we will see you in the next one.